Hi, you're watching the IT Taster channel, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to configure user home folders, or user home directories as they're sometimes known as, using Microsoft Windows Server 2019. But do bear in mind this method will work with earlier versions of Windows Server 2. Now, by creating user home folders on our server, we're providing our users with a dedicated storage area, which is actually located on our server. So that storage is centralized, and that gives us advantages such as being able to back up our data all in one place. Now, don't forget, if you enjoy the video, please give it a like, leave a comment below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to the IT Taster channel. I'm also around on social media too, and I'll leave the links below in the description. So with that said, let's go over to the server in the lab and get started. So let's begin by signing into the server. Server Manager, of course, starts by default. I'm going to open up File Explorer. Now, you'll notice on my test server in the lab, I have two drives set up here. I have my C drive, my C partition, which contains the Windows Server 2019 operating system and system files. And I've also set up a new volume drive E, which I intend to use for test data. Now, it's also a good idea to consider this sort of thing in a production environment as well. I like to keep the operating system files separate from things like user files, user data, and application data as well. Now, you may have noticed that this server is also a domain controller. It's running Active Directory domain services. And again, in a production environment, we wouldn't tend to have a domain controller hosting user files and user data because it's not great for security. It's a good idea to keep these sort of things separate. So with that said, I'm going to click on my E drive and I'm going to create a new folder. And this is going to be the master folder that is going to store all of my user home folders. So I'm going to call it home folders. And I'm going to set up some NTFS permissions first. So right click the folder, choose properties, choose security to access our NTFS permissions. Now, the permissions that we see here are the permissions that we've inherited from our E drive itself. So the first thing I'm going to do is click Advanced, and I'm going to disable inheritance on this particular folder. I'm going to convert those inherited permissions into explicit permissions on my folder and click OK. The next thing I'm going to do is click Edit and make a few changes here. I'm going to remove the users group from here. I'm going to keep creator owner. I'm going to keep the system group as well, which as you can see has full control. I'm going to also keep administrators. Now there is one more group I'm going to add. I'm going to add backup operators. The reason I'm going to do that is to make it easier for any backup software, any backup operators that need to backup user home folders. And I'm going to assign full control to the backup operators group. Okay, so that's created our home folders folder and we've set up our NTFS permissions. The next thing we need to do is share the folder. So to do that, right click the folder again, go to properties and choose sharing. I'm going to use select advanced sharing here and tick share this folder. And I'm going to put an underscore in there. I'm going to call my share home underscore folders. And I'm also going to pop a dollar on the end there, a dollar sign. This makes the share a hidden share. The next thing I'm going to do is to add some permissions as to who can access this share, because by default, as you can see, everyone has read-only access to the share. So I'm going to remove the everyone group and I'm going to add domain users and click OK. And I'm going to assign domain users, I'm going to assign them full control. and click OK. So we now have our home folders, master folder set up, and we've also shared the home folders folder as well. So I'm just going to minimize that. The next thing we need to do is go into Active Directory Users and Computers, where we do most of our administration from. And in here, I'm going to create a new user. I'm going to create a user called John. Click Next. And I'm going to assign a password. And I'm going to set password never expires and click Next. So now that we have a user to work with, I'm going to go back into the user and I'm going to click the profile tab. And this is where we have the opportunity to set a path to the home folder that we created. So I'm going to click Connect. I'm going to choose a drive letter that will be assigned for my home folder. I'm going to use H for home. And then I need to specify the path to the home folder, which is --, the server name, which is server one, --, the share name, which was home_folders$, --, and then I'm going to use a wildcard, %username%. And basically, this wildcard will represent the username. I like to do this because it makes sure that when you are specifying a user's home folder, providing obviously you've set the account up properly, the home folder's name will be spelt correctly. And click OK. So now if we just go back to File Explorer and we go into Home Folders, you'll see that a home folder for the user John has been created. And if we right click it and go to Properties, go to Security, we can see that we've got some new permissions there. We've got the user John who has been assigned a full control permission to this folder. So we've set up our home folder, we've shared it, and we've assigned it to a user. So let's log on to a Windows 10 client computer now so we can see how it looks to a user on the network. So I'm going to sign in to my Windows 10 workstation as my newly created user John so that we can take a look at things from a client computer perspective and an end user. So I'm going to open up File Explorer and click on this PC. And you'll notice we have our local C drive as always, but underneath that in network locations, we have a drive H, which of course is our home folder on the server. So I can click on drive H just like any other drive, and I'm going to create a new document in there, create a new text document, and we'll call it ittaster. And this document will actually be saved within the home folder on the server. And there's a big advantage to this, of course. We're saving our data in one place, which makes it much easier to back up. It means our data won't be spread all over the network, which makes a server admin's job much, much easier. Well, that brings us to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please give the video a like and drop a comment below. Don't forget, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the ittaster channel. I'm also around on social media too, and I've left the links below in the description. So, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.